Hi again, everyone. Chris Tisdell here again. In this presentation, I'm going to continue my series of videos on complex numbers. Now, in previous presentations, we talked about different forms of a complex number. So you've got the Cartesian form, the polar trig form, and the polar exponential form. And in this presentation, I'm going to use this polar exponential form in an example. So let me share my screen with you and we can get started. Okay, so here is the example that I'm going to look at. You're given two complex numbers, Z and W, and Q is defined to be this quotient involving Z and W. We're asked to calculate the modulus of Q and the principal argument of Q. So we've got two complex numbers. We raise them to various powers and divide, get a new complex number. What is the modulus, or the length, if you like, of that new complex number, and what is the principal argument of that new complex number? Okay, so the ideas we're going to use will involve the polar exponential form. Okay, so this is a polar exponential form. R is a distance or a length called the modulus, and theta is an angle. Okay, so let's draw a picture of these two complex numbers on the same complex plane. So here we've got the imaginary axis, here we've got the real axis. Let's plot Z first. So 1 plus I. So we go 1 unit here and 1 unit up there. So that's going to be Z. And W, we go 1 unit this way and root 3 units this way. Okay, so this will be your W. Okay, so if we draw some line segments joining those points to the origin, then to put these two complex numbers in polar form, we need an angle to the positive real axis, and we need a length. Okay, now the way you can come up with those things, you can do it visually or by applying various formulae, but I like to do it visually. Okay, when we can. So if you look here, we can have a right angle triangle associated with Z. Okay, this length is 1, this length is 1. By Pythagoras, this length has to be root 2. And we know from basic trigonometry, basically we've got a triangle where these two angles must be equal, and they're going to be pi on 4. So the length, or the modulus of Z, is root 2, and the angle to the positive real axis is pi on 4. Now, similarly for W, you've got another right-angled triangle, which is something like this. We know that the base is 1, the height is root 3, and again, by Pythagoras, the hypotenuse, which is the length we want, is going to be 2. Okay, again, this is another special triangle from trigonometry, one of the two special triangles. This angle here is going to be pi on 6. And this angle here is going to be pi on 3. Now, this angle here is going to be this smaller angle down here. What we really want is this angle here. So we know the whole thing has to be pi on 2. So this angle here would be actually pi on 3, 60 degrees if you like. Okay, because we start at the positive real axis and we rotate clockwise, the opposite way to go to Z, it would be negative. Okay, so let me just write some of these things down. So from our diagram, now if you want to use the formulae to compute this, you know, you can do that. But for me, I always like to draw diagrams when possible, because it gives you a simple visual way to interpret things. Okay, so Z equals Re to the I theta, where R is the modulus or the length, and theta is an angle to the positive real axis. So here we're going to have root 2 And the angle is pi on 4. Okay, similarly, what about W? Well, W is 2 units from the origin, and the angle in the rotating from the positive real axis clockwise, we have to go rotate pi on 3 or 60 degrees in the clockwise direction. So that's going to mean a negative sign here. Okay, so we can now use these things, use these forms, these polar trig forms, to calculate Q, and then we can look at its modulus and its principal argument. Okay, so let's work out Q first, and then we'll worry about its length. Okay, so it's z to the 6th over w to the 5. So that is just this. To the 6th all over this to the power 5. And then we can just use our index or power laws. You would distribute the 6, distribute the 5 accordingly. Okay, so root 2 to the power 6, that's just the same as 2 cubed. E to the I pi on 4, or to the power 6, well, that's just e to the I 6 pi. On 4. So you just multiply, and on the bottom we're going to get 2 to the power 5 times e to the negative I 5 pi on 3. So what we want to do is simplify this. So if you bring, so obviously the 2's will cancel and you'll get 2 squared on the bottom, which is going to be 4. You can use the power laws or the index laws to bring that up to the top and then simplify. We're going to get e to the pi I times 3 and 1/6. Okay, so you just might want to put in a step there where you simplify this. Okay, but this is what you should get. Okay, now without doing anything more to this, I can immediately solve part A, because this number here in the polar exponential form denotes a length or a modulus. So the modulus of Q is going to be 1/4. Okay, so that's A done. Principal argument. Now, principal argument is the angle associated with Q that lies between negative pi and pi. And if you look at this angle here, you've got 3 and 1/6 pi. That is not between negative pi and pi. Okay, so what we can do is basically look at this and try to break it down a bit. So 3 pi on 6. So I want to go, because it's positive, I go anti-clockwise, and I'll go 1 pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, and then another pi on 6. Okay, so my Q is going to lie somewhere around there. Okay. Now, to simplify this further, what I want is to get to that Q point with some angle between negative pi and pi. So I start here, and actually I would go in the clockwise direction. Okay, now if that little angle is pi on 6, this larger angle will be 5 pi on 6. And because we rotate clockwise, the argument will be, principal argument will be negative 5 pi on 6. Okay, so let me just write this down. Okay, so I've just sort of squished that in there now. So that's my Q. And from this, we can write down A and B. We thus have Q is, modulus Q is 1/4. And for B, we have the principal argument, which is always between negative pi and pi. In my series of videos, that'll be that angle there, so negative 5 pi on 6. Now, some books have the principal argument between 0 and 2 pi, but I'm not going to do it that way. Okay, so a couple of things. Always draw a diagram if you can. It will simplify the calculations, less algebra, less chance to make a mistake, I would think. As you can see, the polar trig form is used to simplify powers and multiplications and divisions. And if you wanted to nitpick a little bit, you could say, oh, hang on, Chris, I can easily calculate that just from those two forms. I can calculate the length of that, calculate the length of that, and then, you know, take that length to the power 6, that length to the power 5, and divide. Yes, you could do that, but that won't help you in the second part in determining the angle. Okay, so that's my presentation. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you found it useful. In forthcoming videos, I'll keep doing some more examples involving polar exponential, polar trig exponential forms. Okay, so please join me for those presentations. If you have any comments, any questions, feel free to post a comment. Thanks for watching. Bye.